Good afternoon. It's my honor today to let you all know that I tend to appoint New Jersey State Attorney General Jeff Chiesa to be New Jersey's next United States Senator. I've obviously known Jeff for 22 years, and he has been an extraordinary public servant in the time that I've gotten to know him. Graduate of the University of Notre Dame and Catholic University of America Law School, an outstanding private practice attorney, assistant United States attorney rising to leadership positions in the United States Attorney's Office, chief counsel to the governor, my first 2 years as governor, and now New Jersey's attorney general. I said on Monday that I was going to select the person who I thought would be the best person to represent New Jersey between now and October 16th, when all New Jerseyans get an opportunity to elect the person to succeed the late Senator Frank Lautenberg. During the last few days, as I've gotten to deliberate on this decision, it became clear to me that Attorney General Chiesa would be the best person to represent the people of the state of New Jersey in the United States Senate. And so I intend to execute all the appropriate documents to effectuate his appointment effective this Monday, June 10th. And I want to thank Jeff and his family for their willingness to once again step in and serve the public in the state of New Jersey. And so it is my honor to introduce for remarks, and then I will come back for questions. It's my honor to introduce for remarks New Jersey's newest United States Senator, Senator Jeff Chiesa.
Good afternoon, everybody. This is an incredible honor for my family and I. The governor has given me some extraordinary chances to serve in public life, none of them that I expected. This probably least of all. But to have this chance to continue to serve in public life is a wonderful opportunity for anybody. I'll use my best judgment and the skill that I have to conduct myself in a way that will make everybody in New Jersey proud, and to do everything I can to advance the interests of the people that live here, as I've tried to do in all the positions that I've had the honor to have. I want to thank Governor Christie for again placing his trust and confidence in me. It really is extraordinary to me that I'm standing here today, again, with his confidence and his support. And I really want to thank my family, because you can't have the chances that I've had, and you can't do the things that I've had a chance to do without the support of your family. My wife Jenny and my children Al and Hannah have been incredibly supportive, and I'm incredibly thankful to them for all that they've done for me, and I look forward to doing my best in this job over the next few months. Thank you.
Questions?
Governor
Michael. Attorney General Chiesa has chosen not to seek the office of United States Senate. He will not be a candidate in the primary or general election, and that's his decision. He decided not to run, seek the office, and I'm perfectly comfortable with that decision. Yeah, Jenna. I went to Jeff and Jenny's house on Monday evening to sit and talk with them about this. And we talked for about an hour and a half on Monday night. They both asked for the overnight to think about whether or not this was something that they were willing to do. Jeff called me on Tuesday morning and told me that, in fact, he didn't call me, he texted me. And he said, I'm in. And that's the way I got the news back from Jeff. So, and the window into my thinking, Jenna, is that I said all along that, you know, and listen, as I said on Monday, I knew this day might come. You know, Senator Lautenberg had been ill, and I knew that this day might come. So I didn't just start thinking about this on Monday. I've been thinking about it on and off for some period of time. But in earnest, I started obviously on Monday morning after I got the news of Senator Lautenberg's death. And by Monday evening, I was pretty certain about what I wanted to do, if he was willing to take it.
Governor,
Matt.
Governor, were you looking for somebody who wouldn't run for office? Was that the decision he made after you offered him the job?
Yeah. I made him the offer. As I told you, he texted me the next morning, said, I'm in. I called him, and I said, great. I said, now, are you going to run for it, or do you just want to serve on the interim basis? And he said, I have no interest in being a political candidate, Governor. I'd rather not run. And I said, fine. It's fine with me, Jeff. If you don't want to run, that's fine.
As your follow-up, what happens to the Attorney General's office in the interim?
Well, obviously, I'm going to have to name an acting Attorney General. And I'm not there yet on that. Matt, we'll probably have something to say about that next week. The Attorney General, you know, doesn't resign on Monday and take office in the United States Senate until Monday. So he's got some very capable people in his front office there that can be considered, and I'll be seeking the Attorney General's advice on that, and then we'll make a decision and announce that, you know, on Monday.
And then he comes back in
I have no idea. I have no idea what's going to happen after October. Let's see what happens after October and what Senator Chiesa's preference is in terms of what he wants to do next in his career. I've made it very clear to Jeff and to Jenny that they've sacrificed a great deal over time at my request, and that you know, they get to decide what they want to do after October 16th. And if they want to come back and serve in some capacity, that's obviously something I'd be willing to consider. And if they don't, believe me, they've given me a lot. And so it's up to them after October 16th. Michael. I don't know that answer, Michael. I know I won't be nominating somebody on Monday. On Monday, I'll be announcing an acting Attorney General, and then whatever happens thereafter will depend on my deliberations going forward and consultations with Senator Chiesa. Michael.
Governor, the only Republican who has entered the race in the primary in August so far is Steve Lonigan, who has been a fairly sharp critic of yours from the right. Do you think he'll have a clear shot, or do you think someone from the more moderate establishment wing of the party will jump in?
Well, first of all, I would disagree with your characterization. I don't think that Steve's been a sharp critic of mine since I've been in office. In fact, we've agreed on much more than we've disagreed on since I've been in office. And so I would disagree with your characterization off the top. And I'm not going to get into speculating about who is going to run and who might run and who might not run. People have until Monday at 4 o'clock to collect 1,000 signatures. And I'll make my evaluation of what I think of the field once the field is set. You know, Steve Lonigan and I have worked pretty well together over the course of the last, you know, 3+ years. And we've disagreed on some issues, we've agreed on others, but that's not atypical for other Republicans who have agreed and disagreed with me as well. But I'm sure in my own mind that there's others that are still considering what's going on. I'm sure some people were waiting to see what I was going to do regarding the appointment of a senator before deciding what they were going to do. And now all the mystery is out of it, except for those people decide whether or not they want to put themselves forward for the office.
Governor, you talk a lot about the need for Republicans to appeal more to the Hispanic community. And I just read the press conference that the immigration bill is going up to debate soon. I'm wondering if this is something you talked to the DRCS about, and whether you have a stance on.
First off, I've taken the normal course that I take in terms of my interactions with Jeff since he's been the Attorney General. He's got a job he's going to be responsible for. It's his job to make those judgments, and I trust him to make those judgments. I've trusted him to do that as Attorney General, and I trust him to do it as United States Senator, or I wouldn't be appointing him. So, no, we haven't had any conversations about any specific pieces of legislation, Senator.
I think the first thing we have to do is to make sure the borders are secure. I think that's probably because I come from a background of law enforcement. From there, these issues are new to me, and the details of them are new to me, and I'll get down there and meet with my colleagues and discuss with them the things that I think make the most sense for the people that I represent.
Yes.
What I can say to you is that, as I said, this is something that's new for me, and My first concern, though, is the border security. And that's, again, that's because of the frame of reference that I come from, both as a federal prosecutor earlier in my career and now as the Attorney General. And as to the other issues that I need to take care of, those will be part of the discussions that I'll have as I get to learn about my new job. This is, as I said earlier, this is all pretty new. And I need to learn about the issues in a way before I can make any meaningful judgments on some of the specifics.
Other questions? Yeah, Heather.
Yes, I'm registered Republican. I believe 2000.
Paul?
Yeah, there's been a lot of criticism from Washington Republicans who thought that you could have made an appointment through November of 2014. Now, the Democrats were going to sue on that. Did you think you could have picked somebody through 2014, or would that have got tied up in the courts and ended up in an election this fall anyway?
Well, I don't know what the result would have been, Paul. I know that we would have been sued for 2014. I mean, the Democrats have made that clear publicly before I even made any announcement. And I think, you know, it's the fault of the legislature for setting up, you know, less than clear statutory guidance on this. And I think as a New Jersey Republican, what I know is these kind of things should not be left to the courts to decide. We typically don't do too well in that regard. So while I can't certainly predict the result, I am a student of history, as are you, and I thought the idea of making a decision that was in the best interest of the people of the state, to give them a voice and a choice for United States Senate, and to do the best I could to keep it out of the courts, would serve the best interest of the people of the state. Yeah, Terry. Listen, there, because of the unclear statutory construction, there was no perfect decision to be made here. And so I went to what my core principles are, which are that I believe people should have the right to make a choice if that's available. And so that's why I made the decision I made. And as far as the ramifications politically, you know, that's for everybody else to decide. My decision was, I had imperfect statutory construction, a history of an activist court in election matters, and a limited set of choices. And I made the choice that I think is in the best interest of the people of New Jersey. And everyone will debate the political effects until we actually see what they are. And then everybody will be a genius in hindsight. You know, it's just how it goes. So it wasn't what part of my consideration, Terry. My consideration was to look at what my options were, and to make the best and most legally defensible choice that I could make.
Do you think the short-term rounding of the signatures by Monday at 4 o'clock give candidates who are interested in running as independents or as disadvantage?
Anybody who thinks they want to run for statewide office and can get 1,000 people to sign a petition in 5 days don't belong running for statewide office. So you don't have that good an organization behind you. You think it's hard to get 1,000 signatures? Wait till you try to get 1,000,000 votes. It'll be a lot harder. Yes.
Governor, if I may, ask the Attorney General, did this come out of left field?
But I knew when the governor called pretty late on Monday and asked to come meet with Jenny and I had an inkling of what we might be talking about. But there was no arm twisting. The decision is one for my wife and my family to make. He's always respected that. He understands that. And it's an extraordinary opportunity. And so there's some disruption for my family life. This will be some time I'll be spending in Washington. But it's an incredible chance to serve. All of the chances I've had have been incredible chances to serve. And I'm incredibly honored to have this one. But there was no arm twisting. I'm incredibly honored. And thankfully, I have my family's support in doing it.
John.
Governor, a lot has been made in the last few days on the cost of this special election.
Yeah.
Being done on the John Stewart show. Yeah. What's your response to this, over the last few days of discussion on that? And also the Democrats have a bill that can move up the general election to coincide with the special election for the U.S. Senate.
So
what do you think about that?
I don't know. There's like 3,000 bills or so that are introduced in every session. This is one of them that'll be on the ash heap as well. Secondly, as to the cost, again, let me be really clear. I understand that I was confronted with a set of imperfect choices, but I don't believe that siding on letting people select their senator and select that person as soon as possible and get them to Washington as soon as possible is something that should be discounted. And what we're talking about is maybe an additional $12 million in cost. Because, as I said on Monday, and some of this may have been misinterpreted, you know, I was going to insist on a primary no matter what. That was non-negotiable with me. I was not going to have state party insiders in either party selecting the candidates to go on the ballot for the United States Senate. So we were going to have a primary no matter what. And given the fact that Senator Lautenberg's death came within one day of our primary, there was no way to do that, obviously, on June 4th. And so we were going to have a primary anyway. My view was, let's get this done as quickly as possible. And remember, the framers of our Constitution, if you go back and look at the 1947 constitutional debates, as I have, the framers of the Constitution made it clear that they wanted federal elections separated from state elections in New Jersey. They made a conscious choice to only have state elections on odd-numbered years because they did not want voters to be conflating federal issues and state issues. Our framers of the 47 Constitution emphasized that in discussions, and I think my decision was faithful to the intent of the Constitution. Now, there's probably not a lot of people who have read those things, but, you know, the fact is, I think this decision is consistent with that, and a $12 million cost, while not insubstantial, is, I don't think, something in the context of a $32 billion budget, something that should dissuade us from giving people an opportunity to get an elected United States senator down there as quickly as we can. Phil.
I loved being Attorney General. I don't know that I'll ever have a better job. I felt that it's a way, having lived here my whole life, was a way to make incredible contributions to the state. Having been a prosecutor, I felt comfortable doing the work. But I think the experiences that I've had, the good fortune to have, allow me to do this job as well. And I only have these chances because of the governor. I don't kid myself. I don't think that there's another governor out there who's going to say, you know what, be my Attorney General someday. So when he gave me that chance, as extraordinary as it was, he asked me to do this. I think so long as my family felt it was okay with them, and that's number one, then I think because of the extraordinary generosity that he's given me in having these opportunities, that if I felt comfortable, my family felt comfortable, it's something that I should do.
Michael. Governor, you and Jeff Chiesa, I believe, were law partners together at Cranford. Did you hire him at
Yes.
And what year was that?
1991.
So you've appointed someone you're very close to personally.
Yes, absolutely. I mean, listen, there's very few people in my life that I know better than Jeff. And I have enormous respect and admiration for him and his integrity and his honesty and his ability. And I think everybody who's watched him in New Jersey, and especially people who have watched him here inside the State House, have come to the same conclusion. I remember saying to him, as I sat in my office listening to his confirmation hearings as Attorney General, that I've rarely ever heard such a kiss-a-thon in my entire life. But Republicans and Democrats both have grown to have great admiration for Attorney General Chiesa. And so, you know, obviously I have a unique view into him because I've known him since he was a brand new lawyer 22 years ago. And we've been together much of the time since then. I've appointed somebody who I have great faith and confidence in, and someone who I know as well as, almost as well as I know my own family. Yeah, Luke.
The Senate is a contentious place to work right now, and certainly votes are usually very thin and marginal. I'm wondering if General Chiesa is ready for that type of atmosphere, and what you think about going to work at a place where oftentimes there's a lot of
Yeah, I think it will be a new experience for me for sure. But as I said, all of the experiences that I've had have been new at the start of them. I've tried to use my best ability and my best judgment in all those spots, and that's what I'll do when I'm there, focusing on what's best for the people of New Jersey and doing the best that I can to represent them in a way that makes them proud.
Charlotte? Oh, I don't mean to interrupt you, but...
in your consideration deliberations, did you weigh the fact that he does not have a background in elected politics, and that by picking somebody without that background, that made him less of a target for some of your critics, or keeps him out of the ideological divide that he's going to inevitably enter once he goes to Washington?
No, I didn't. What I weighed was, who did I think was the best person for the job? And I just believe he's the best person for the job. Jeff brings a great approach to solving problems to this job. Charlie, you can interview dozens and dozens and dozens of people in this building, and I will doubt that you'll find anyone who will have anything bad to say about Jeff Chiesa. That's rare for someone who's held. You've been around for a long time. Somebody who's been the chief counsel to the governor for 2 years, that can often be a very difficult and contentious position as well, and someone who's been the state attorney general now for 18 months. Both find, you won't find anybody, I think, who has anything bad to say about Jeff, and I think that is a reflection on his integrity and his personality. And I think sending that kind of person during these times down to the United States Senate is something they need. And so I think it'll be a good thing to have him down there. And elected politics or not was not really something that I was concerned about, because we've had plenty of people who have never run for office before who wound up running for the United States Senate and winning beforehand, Frank Lautenberg and John Corzine. So, you know, it's not necessarily a prerequisite to run for the job. But, you know, Jeff has decided he does not want to run for the job. That's his choice. And I'm supportive of it if that's what he believes is the best thing to do. But by the same token, we'd be clear. If he had told me I want to run for the job, I would have been incredibly supportive of that as well if that's what he wanted to do. And anybody who knows Jeff knows that he's got a mind of his own.
Number for you. It's 212 456 4665. 4665. 4665.